Hello. Thank you for being here this afternoon. This presentation is an example of what a civil disaster risk reduction Deer Air Trainers Reserve could be. Before going any further, I would like to introduce Mrs. Sylvette Piron, President of the French Institute of Major Risk Trainers, IFO-RME. Following our presentation, you will be given the opportunity to ask a question, which we will answer as best as possible, but only after the presentation, please. Next to me is also Sébastien Michel of the Environmental Ministry, whose English is better than ours. So behind the wall, after the presentation, we could answer your question. If you don't mind, I would like to take a few minutes of your time to introduce myself too. I've been working in this field, major risk prevention and education, for 12 years at the French Institute of Major Risk Trainers. And I'm especially in charge of developing training tools and partnerships. Donc, I'm Evelyne Alain. Allez-y. Our presentation will be divided into three parts. The first point is trainers network mission and goals. The second point, example of action and network tools. And the third point, outcomes and results. The mission and goals. As surprising it may be, the major risk prevention culture in French is very limited because of a very low frequency of both natural and technological catastrophes. This is the reason why, in 1990, to build its prevention policy against major environmental risks, France came up with a new concept based on young people education and set up a network of trainers called Major Risk Education. IFO-RME is in charge of running this DRR trainers network with initial trains and continual trains on an annual basis. The members of this network come both from the national education system and other state institutions, including, for example, firemen, local authorities, hospital practitioners, etc. How to become a trainer? By participating in an initial training session of 5 days. This training session is required by the Environmental Ministry and set up by the French Institute IFO-RME. Today, the trainer network counts about 400 voluntary members, including international people from Benin, Senegal, Spain, Algeria, and Andorra. This reserve is similar to an experimental hub for the risk specialist. The goals of this trainer network are improve how citizens take into account major risk reduction and environmental protection issues throughout their life. Train new trainers to increase the size of the trainer reserve. Conceive and spread out educational tools and enlarge initiatives and set up international exchanges of this subject, as well as helping schools to ensure their safety against major risk through the PPMS is a specific school safety plan, and helping state and local authority. Develop initiative international exchange, and after, help schools to ensure with the PPMS is a specific plan. And help the state local authority to implement public information. The general philosophy behind that is to coordinate two main momentums. On the one hand, information to the population, which is normally performed by the city hall, along with PCS, Plan Communal de Sauvegarde, is it the plan to be prepared in case of crisis, and DCRIM, information document for the population about major risk, an information document. And on the other end, the PPMS, to be prepared in case of crisis, that applies in schools and requires educational action through curricula, curricula, programs, or transversal subjects. What are our trainers doing? Alors, some examples are described in the path follows. Voilà. Please, could you send the video? Now, first, they spread out the knowledge of their professional sphere, and they can initiate projects of training and tools.
Oui. Oui, je viens d'entendre que la situation météorologique allait encore se dégrader. Ah, Météo France passe en vigilance rouge. Ok, je déclenche le plan particulier de mise en sûreté des élèves et des personnels. Je vous tiens au courant. Le PPMS est activé.
Le PPMS est activé. Veuillez rejoindre les zones de mise à l'abri. Météo France annonce des vents très violents. Attention, ceci n'est pas un exercice.
Bien, le plan particulier de mise en sûreté est activé. Donc nous, nous restons ici. Maureen, tu baisses le store de cette fenêtre.
C'est parti.
Quentin, tu poses du ruban adhésif sur l'autre fenêtre. Hein? Le store est cassé. Fais un grand X pour éviter que la vitre ne vole en éclats, s'il te plaît.
Ok. Mais t'es qui, lui?
Quentin.
Hein?
Si tu as terminé, ne reste pas scotché à la fenêtre.
Des rafales de vent violents sont attendues pour le milieu de l'après-midi. Elles pourront atteindre 150 km/h. La mise à l'abri est maintenue jusqu'à nouvel ordre. Des sandwichs vous seront distribués pour le déjeuner. Merci de votre attention.
Puisque nous sommes ensemble pour une durée indéterminée, je vais vous parler de la vigilance rouge. En fait, la vigilance météorologique est en place depuis 2002. Et en près de 10 ans, Météo France n'a lancé que 7 alertes rouges. Regardez ce graphique. C'est un événement vraiment exceptionnel. Ces chiffres en témoignent. Il y a rarement plus d'un épisode de vigilance rouge par an dans nos régions. Je vous rappelle qu'en 2009, la tempête Klaus a provoqué 12 morts. Vous comprenez combien il est important de rester à l'abri.
Où est passé Quentin?
Ah oui, tiens.
Ah, je suis sûr qu'il est parti voir Salima, ce baltringue. Attends. Je l'appelle. Oh, ça passe pas.
Avec le mien, peut... Oh non,
pas de réseau. Oh my god.
Mais... Qu'est-ce que tu fais là, toi? La vigilance rouge est levée. Mais le vent souffle encore et il a pu provoquer des dégâts sur les routes.
Par précaution, les externes passeront la nuit dans l'établissement. Nous sommes en contact avec les autorités.
Sortez calmement, s'il vous plaît.
Venez me faire part de toute situation particulière.
Calmement.
This film was created by the RISO, the network, the DRL Trainer Network, and with a partnership with Météo France, the official institution that do the prediction the weather prediction in France. So this network first spread out the knowledge to the professional sphere. Second, they can initiate projects of training, project of action, or create with local partner a cultural event about risk prevention and conceive tools to make adults and children aware of the problem. In France, we have lots of rules in the field of the major risk prevention which are sufficient. Some state institutions comply with the applicable rules, but others don't. Today, the strategy that we support is to acknowledge those that comply. In order to do so, the network has developed the Orange Shield, whose concept is to value schools that are taking the right approaches to implement safety procedures against major hazard, PPMS, and educational action. The school managers have to complete a form on a website, a questionnaire with only 30 questions focusing on the basics. Il faut avancer. Ouais, encore. Voilà. The result for the first year of experimentation shows the difficulties met by the school to become a resilient school. On out of 130 schools, which is not a lot compared with the total number of schools in France, donc on out of 130 schools that voluntarily registered to the website, only 22 obtained their shield. The main reason is that schools had not set up the appropriate educational program. However, this should not be considered as a failure, in as much as the trainer have been able to help the school make progress and to reach the requested level to be granted the Orange Shield. In the near future, the Orange Shield could be included in the program for obtaining the Orange Banner that reward resilient cities. In accordance with the YOGO framework of action, the Ecolabel would actively support the risk reduction education, the memory and interpretation of major catastrophes, the preservation of cultural properties, the necessary training for activity continuation within services and enterprises. The value of a school, it's a manager school. Encore. Alors. The next example is a guide of action and actors to develop the major risk prevention culture. It embodies through an interactive website where the action of the private and public sphere and civil society can post their noticeable and duplicable action. It is a tool to share practices, experiences, and results with other actors. It is a toolbox for action and potential new partnerships. To this day, within a very short period of time, we have about 100 described initiatives, and it is only the beginning. To conclude, it is worth noting that quantitatively, si vous voulez, the major risk and education trainer network represents. Alors, allez-y, avancez, parce qu'il faut finir, voilà. 1,000 trained people since 1990, and about 400 really active today. The measurement of their action for the previous year indicates about more than 700 interventions that involved about 20,000 people. We are, however, facing difficulties, which are as follows: build and share a similar approach about major risk prevention for people from various spheres, technical, educational, political spheres. The time spent by trainer shows huge variation from one location to another. In fact, trainer invest in their professional time or in addition to their normal job on a voluntary basis. Today, the acknowledgement of the skill set of our trainers is guaranteed by three ministries. The Environmental Ministry has been supporting IFO-RME since the very beginning, sharing with us their great expertise. Thank you for your attention. if you have some question, we can answer you behind this wall in the French delegate stand. Thanks.